Hey guys, today we're going to be cleaning out our throttle body. Now last episode you guys saw us clean out the mass airflow sensor. So while we're in there, we might as well clean out the throttle body. Whenever working on your vehicle or dealing with an electronic device, you want to remove the negative terminal off the battery first. Now for our particular car, we can do the ECU reset procedure quite easily. But if you're driving a different type of vehicle and you want to make sure that the vehicle can relearn all the new parameters, with the vehicle's battery disconnected, go ahead and honk the horn and turn on the lights. Basically, you want to discharge the energy out of the caps out of the factory computer. So if you're getting a really bad idle, you have poor fuel economy, or you maybe even have a check engine light, you might also want to make sure that your throttle body is clean so it can operate properly. Now we go ahead and remove our intake tube. Now what you'll notice here that there is a tube going from here, there's a vacuum tube, and it actually leads straight to our valve cover. So under wide open throttle for this particular vehicle, it will create vacuum and you may get some oil vapors going into the throttle body. This is how they get dirty. Now I can perform this job with this tube here, but it's kind of hard for you guys to see. So let's just get it out of the way. With the intake tube out of the way, we can go ahead and unplug our throttle body from its electrical connection. Now you're ready to remove it. It doesn't really matter where you start, whatever you're comfortable with. I've seen people start at the easiest bolts first. I like to start typically, if everything's accessible, I start with the hardest stuff first. So I'm going to go ahead and take out this bottom corner one because I don't want to drop it. It's going to be a lot easier for me to manage the other bolts. Now, depending on your gasket system that you have in here, it may or may not get caught on the thread, so the bolt might not come out all the way. Mine are coming out. We do have a copper gasket on here because we've actually bypassed the coolant lines going through the throttle by itself. We wanted to achieve a colder charge on this car, and bypass the throttle body for coolant does that because it warms it up. The downside is though, if you catch yourself in colder situations, you may have issues with the throttle body freezing. So what we've done is Motordyne makes one where we have a copper gasket in here that still flows coolant through it to warm it up to prevent freezing, but doesn't make it that it gets the throttle body so warm. So it's the best of both worlds because I am building a touring car, and let's say I decide to drive this thing in October, I can. It doesn't get freezing, but I always want to avoid that possibility. So now that's nice and loose, I'm supporting it underneath. I don't want to just have everything dangling loose off the threads on this. So if you have coolant lines, you're gonna have to release those. We don't, we're gonna catch our gasket and pull it all out. So looking inside our intake manifold, we did an MRF2 a while ago with a plenum spacer. So we cleaned out the whole top end and started from scratch. And you can see it's very, very clean. And you can see that there's these machine parts on our throttle body spacer. It's actually kind of collecting any carbon that were to make its way up. But it's not like on this side, it shoots a lot. It's actually on the PCV side where you're going to get more carbon buildup, and that's why we run an oil catch can. It's actually underneath that manual over here. So we run an oil catch can. We run a closed system on this car. The reason being is I think it's the most efficient
It's how the engineers intended for the PCV system to work. I would like to run a catch can on this side eventually, but as you can see, it's not, from how much I'm driving the car, it's not a huge concern for me to have a catch can on the side. I just have to monitor it.
Cleaning the throttle body is a simple procedure, but you can see with it off the car, there's a couple things. One, we can actually really see what's going on in here too. I have cleaned out throttle bodies on the vehicle, and when you spray a lot of this stuff into the intake manifold and it doesn't dry up, you have such a hard time starting it. I guess someone could debate that by spraying this in the intake manifold, you can loosen up some carbon, because that's technically what you're doing with seafoam, is you're loosening up all the carbon in the intake manifold and it's hitting your intake valves and it's going to get that clean. Sure, we can debate that. But you're going to have a lot easier starting and you're going to do a lot better job cleaning it, especially the backside with this off of the vehicle. So we're going to do inspection, see what's going on. You can see this is very clean. We've cleaned a couple times, but if we look carefully around the rim, because I wouldn't touch the throttle body before, it is building up. There's a little bit of buildup in there. What that's going to cause is the butterfly might not close properly. So another thing is when you're dealing with electronic pieces like this, it's better to have it off the car, because if, let's say, you were in a rush, you didn't disconnect the negative terminal, and then you started playing with the butterfly, it might think it's a different calibration, and it doesn't know the position of the throttle body. These things are sensitive. So that's why we're going to do the relearn procedure after. That's why we discharge the caps in the factory computer, because you want it to relearn the new parameters. Also, if there's a bunch of carbon built up here and the computer is compensating for that, now that we've removed it, now it's going to a more closed position, the computer again has to compensate for that. So we're going to just quickly clean in here to help break apart anything and let it soak for a bit. Okay, now that we let it soak, we can open up the butterfly by hand. And if you do close it, be nice and easy. So you can either put something in here to help hold it. I don't have a problem with holding it open with my hand. And I can take an old toothbrush and start scrubbing away at all that carbon buildup. We're also using CRC throttle body cleaner. So this is going to be safe. It's going to be aggressive enough to remove the carbon, but if there's some sort of coating on this, it's not going to break that down. Because a lot of these times, you notice it's bare metal in here, but it never corrodes. There's a coating in there, and that can also, that coating can help with airflow and corrosion protection. So we're just going to keep doing this. You know, we can take our rag or shop towel and we can clean it, make sure it's a clean one. And we're just going to keep doing that. Now that you've used the brush to get rid of most of the big stuff, you might have a bunch of really caked on thinner layers of carbon there. So spraying the throttle body cleaner again and taking your clean rag and really just scrubbing away at it and removing it's going to make a big difference of how much of that carbon that you can remove. Okay, we're pretty much done cleaning the inside. Now, before I put this back onto the vehicle, I'm going to quickly clean the mating surface where the gasket meets the intake manifold. I want to make sure that this is clean of any debris, especially on the edge. Maybe you've been cleaning a lot and you got a bunch of carbon buildup in there. See, there's a bunch of stuff coming off of there. Okay, we're pretty much done, so I'm just going to rinse it out with carb cleaner completely. And you see, like, this was a fairly clean throttle body when we took it out. Like, it's been cleaned before, not to this detail, but we were cleaning the inlet side of it and wiping it down. and basically all that was really left is we really didn't touch the part where the butterfly closes and meets up with the housing. But you can see, like, look at all that carbon that came out, like, look at all this, and that's just from that one little spot. So you can imagine how much carbon buildup you'd have on a throttle body that isn't really cleaned that often. While I'm allowing the throttle body to dry, I might as well clean out the plug for the electronic control. So this one is electrical contact cleaner, and you have to make sure that it's designed for this purpose. So this one also says safe on most plastics. You don't want to put something on plastic that's going to degrade over time, because then you're going to have another issue and you might have an expensive fix because plastic starts breaking apart. And now we'll just let that all dry. Now before I put on the car, I might as well clean up the whole exterior of the housing. That way everything looks nice when we get it back on there. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and put our throttle body back on. So if you wanted to, you can clean out the intake manifold. We're actually gonna be taking off the top end of this engine later on next year. So we're gonna be doing a lot of other cleaning and changing out parts possibly. So I'm not gonna go do that. So you got your new gasket on here, and I'm going to put one bolt through it and through our gasket. This is gonna help me line up onto our throttle body spacer. I'm gonna put another one on right now. Through the gasket. Checking out our Haynes manual, we can see that the throttle body requires 75 inch pounds. Now, I don't like dealing with soft metals like this, especially if you're not doing it every day. So I'll actually go up in increments. So I start off at 40, then I went 50, then I went to the 75. Because, you know, you start off going all the way to 75, you're like, oh, I don't know, like, is this going to snap? So we're just taking our time with it. This one over here is a pain in the butt. So yeah, if you're not sure if it doesn't feel right, start off at a low setting. That way you know your torque wrench is working and move up in increments. It'll probably feel a lot more comfortable if you do it that way. So one other thing I'm going to do, this one's optional, is I'm going to put a thin layer of dielectric grease inside this plug. It's safe for plastics, and I'm going to work the plug a little bit, a couple times, and then snap it on. Now, a lot of people are going to say that you can't do that, it's going to impede the connection. It doesn't. Dielectric grease, especially if you unplug it a bunch of times, it has a very good property as far as displacing. And what it's going to do is it's going to create a membrane inside that plug. In case there's any moisture getting in there, it's going to help protect those metal prongs, and then you're going to avoid any corrosion issues. So now I have my mass airflow plugged back in, and I have the throttle body plugged in, and I hooked up the negative terminal of the battery. So what I want to do is I'm going to check for operation of the unit. So we're going to do open throttle, we're going to do partial throttle, quarter, half, anywhere where I feel that the pedal is, I want to make sure that the throttle body is mimicking my actions. And before you put everything back together, you want to make sure you put this vacuum tube back on. Now, a couple things when you guys are putting your intake tube back on. One, make sure that when you're placing it on, the bottom part is going on easy. It's very easy, especially on the factory tube, I find, to push it on and you're trying to force it on and it folds underneath, and that can create an engine code. You might get a lean code after that because you might be putting in a bunch of unmetered air into the motor. So feel underneath, make sure that it is not folding. Very easy to do. And I have a Mishimoto intake tube, so I like to put these clamps, the fastener, down here. I don't think it looks good up here, and I don't want to be near all the electronics because I think I'm just going to go cockeyed. There's not enough room in here, so there's plenty of room over here by the plenum. So I'm going to tuck it down there and tighten it, and you don't see it as much. So this is just one of those little things you can do when you're arranging your couplers that you get a nice clean look, and it's easy to service later down the road.
With everything back together, let's go ahead and do the ECU reset.
Okay, the first thing we do is we're going to turn the ignition on. Now you're going to count to three. One Mississippi, two Mississippi, three Mississippi.
Now I'm going to press on the accelerator pedal five times. One, two, three, four, five. After the five times, you're going to let go right away and you're going to count to 10, not 7. A lot of the instructions say 7. So you go one Mississippi, two Mississippi, go all the way to 10. After that, you're going to fully press the pedal. Now you're going to count to 12 seconds. One Mississippi, two Mississippi. We're going to count all the way up to 12. And then we're going to release the pedal. During this, the SES light just start blinking. Now, while you see it blinking, when you hit 12 seconds, release the gas pedal and count to 10. Okay, at this point you see it blinking, you've counted to 12 seconds, now you're going to release. Now you're going to count again to 10 seconds. 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi. You're going to go all the way to 10 seconds. After 10, you're going to hit the pedal down again. And then you're going to count to 10 seconds right after you hit it. So you go 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi. After that, you're going to release. Okay, let's try doing this in a full sequence now. Now the last step is you shut off the ignition and turn the engine back on. Well, I hope this video helps you guys out. As you can see, it's not a hard procedure to do at all. Even if you have to do the relearn, it's not a big deal. And I think this is one of those things, like if you're dealing with a car with a lot of miles on it and you're changing out maybe coil packs, you're changing out the spark plugs and you have all this apart, now is a good time to clean out that throttle body because that's going to help you with your engine performance.